firstly, I would like to thank one and all for giving me an opportunity that I can stand in front of you and have this platform in front of you. So today I'm going to talk about a person who's very close to me. I've been with him throughout his hard times, his good times. Every nook and corner, I've been with that person. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that person today. So there is this person. Let me tell you the name in the later part. So he is very energetic. He is very good. Of course, lacking back in studies, that's the other way around. But yes, he was really good. And so his days began after his education. What he thought was like immediately get into a job, and he was doing it. It was great doing a job and being a team lead over there and then moving into training part. It was really great. So what he thought is like, why don't I just get into master's and just stay there with my sister, probably with his brother. So he never really gave it a try to come into US until and unless he gave a thought to invent something, I would say. Or to be precise, I would say to probably eradicate one of the problems that India is going back in India. So, and then in the later part, just fast forward about an year or a year and a half, what happened is that this person wrote his GRE, IELTS and everything, and then there came this day wherein he had to, for the very first time, get into the flight and leave everybody, his family, his friends, his neighbors, his cousins, his girl, everything. So he had to leave back, and then he has to get onto the flight and travel 24 hours, or 32 hours to be precise, to a very long distance, to an unknown place where there is nobody for him. So 21 years or 22 years of life for him is different, and the life which is going to be for him is different. So there is no comparison, and he wasn't actually sure how he's gonna handle that. All he was very excited to that he's going out to US, but he never knew what actually US is all about until he stepped into the flight. So I still remember I was there at that day when this guy took a flight. So I went to the airport with him. So it was very fortunate that he had his friends with him. And he came to know that in about the next 2 hours he's gonna leave his family. So he sat in a car with his friends rather than with the family, because I know that sitting with their family he's gonna be a little more emotional. So he was like with the full volume of music sitting in the car with his friends traveling towards the airport. And then I remember one of our friends started to weep a little. It was like, okay, relax, it's gonna happen and everything is cool. And then everybody in the car slowly started to weep, weep, weep. And fortunately, even the driver, who doesn't even know anybody in the car, even he started to weep, because he was so emotional, so attached to the bond that someone is leaving to US, leaving his parents alone. So he was being on the parent side, very emotional. And then the boy never felt anything, not even a drop turned out of his eye. I wondered how could that happen. So everybody, his friends, his family, everybody in the airport with the luggage, they were crying and weeping. And this boy was like, okay, I'm leaving to US, so that's not a problem to me. Come on, chill now. That is what his character was until he left everybody and just stepped into the airport. The moment he stepped into the airport, it was 32 hours of journey, all alone, just with two bags of luggage, with a phone in his hand, with not at all any SIM or signals or Wi-Fi. Just sitting in the seat of a plane, thinking about a family, thinking about his girl, thinking about his neighbors, thinking about India, thinking about how he's gonna live from tomorrow without anything being taught to him. And today, I am here, and